Antah Sākshiņe Namah.
Om Antah Sākshiņe Namah.
Om Antaryamine Namah.
Om Antaryamine Namah.
Om Anandaya Namah.
Om Anandaya Namah.
Om Atmaswarupaya Namah.
Om Atmaswarupaya Namah. Antah Sākshiņe Namah. As you know, Guruji put these as alphabetical order, but his way of thinking also is so logical that they somehow fall into a beautiful link or a chain, but not necessarily it is a chain of developing thoughts. All are indicators of the truth, so of course they relate to each other. Antah Sākshiņe Namah. Where is it that we can find Him, find the truth, find God, find the reality? At the same time, one will think that, oh, we've not met Gurudev. Gurudev is not here. But Antah Sākshiņe Namah means he is Antah Sākshi. Antah means inside. Sākshi means the witness. Antah Sākshi. In fact, when Gurudev was leaving from Washington, D.C. after his talks there, and his health was deteriorating very, very, and people were telling him that the doctors actually told him that you're not going to get a heart attack, you are under a heart attack right now. Yeah. And he was saying that as long as my heart can beat, I have to love the people. And he left from Washington, D.C., reached San Diego. He was supposed to go to LA. He was supposed to go, but one devotee had insisted, and he's there very close to Coimbatore. Just recently he had come to our, I met him, and he was telling me the story. I said, I want to hear from you. Because Gurudev had the final heart attack in his house. And he had said, actually my wife was devoted to Gurudev, and she had told, you come to my house for Bhiksha, and Gurudev had given his word. Actually, he would have gone directly to San Francisco. Or LA, I think LA is close, sorry, it was LA. He would have gone directly to LA. But he went to San Diego. And also it's very interesting, San Diego, you know, in Spanish means saint goes to heaven. So from Sydney to San Diego, he traveled around the world with that heart condition, only 15%. So when he was leaving from Washington, D.C., and that last photograph has been pictured, he's entering the car, and this little girl goes and asks, the girl is not in the picture, but the girl asked, or child asked Gurudev, Gurudev, when will I see you again? And Gurudev just smiled and told that child, just look into your heart. Whenever you look into your heart, you will find me there. About the truth or the Lord, it is said, Antah Sākshi and Antaryami. Antah Sākshi means one who is the inner witness. And Antaryami means one who is the inner regulator, controller. Antah Sākshi, one who is the witness. Now, whom do you call as a witness? Means one who was there to see an incident, no? Or say even an accident. One who was there, but who was not involved in that accident, not involved in that incident, not involved in the crime also. That person you call as a witness. In the scriptures, the Atma, the self, has been indicated as Sakshi, Sakshat, Ikshate, one who sees without any instrument or without any means, or one who is uninvolved with what he sees, is called as witness. And that is given as an indicator to recognize yourself. This is a beautiful story Gurudev used to tell us. And when you tell it to the children, you use the word God in that manner. I heard that from my grandmother also as a kid. And that story, which is very common, but Gurudev used to tell that, that one guru told his disciples that here is a bird and you're not supposed to kill any creature, and therefore killing or violence is considered as, or himsa is considered as, the greatest adharma. Go commit this sin where no one is watching. No one is watching. Not actually sin, but think of killing this bird where no one is watching. So everybody found such a place where they could go and kill the bird where no one is watching. But one child came up and told the guru, he says, I cannot commit a sin anywhere. He said, you couldn't find any place where there was nobody? He says, no. Others said, even there are places where God doesn't watch. You go in a dark cave, how can God watch? And that child says, that wherever I went, even if there was no one watching, even if it was pitch dark, I was watching it. How can you say nobody was watching? Who is that I that watches everything? Now everybody's into I watch. But who is that I that watches everything of yours? What you see, hear, smell, taste, touch, what you feel, what you think, is there right now someone who's watching it? Who is the knower even of your equipments, body, mind, and intellect, and who requires no other equipment to see? Have you ever thought, you think that you see with your eyes and your eyes are the seer? Don't you think? But tell me, when your eyes are shut, with what sight do you see your dream as vividly as you see the world? So is the seeing in your eyes, or there is a seer who can see even when your eyes are closed? That one is called as Sakshi. Antah Sakshi. One who knows every thought of yours. One who knows every experience of yours. From whom not even a single thought of yours can escape without being noticed. That consciousness is the Sakshi. Try to recognize that witness who seems to be knowing not only your body, your senses, mind, and intellect, but even what you call yourself as I, this ego. And therefore Gurudev said, close your eyes and look into the core of your personality. You will find me there. How? As the witness of your thoughts. And I'm telling you, nothing or no one could escape without Gurudev knowing what was happening. People think that, you know, somebody must have gone and reported that night we slept very late, but we were trying to be very quiet in our room and we were just sitting whispering each other. But even that Gurudev would know in the camps. But the most amazing thing was, and for us it was a direct experience. We were just two or three youngsters who had gone for the camp. It was a long marathon camp. 1.5 months or 2 months we were at Siddhabadi, and we were serious youngsters, we were ready to study. So after his discourses, whenever we had free time, we would go, and there were no walls, so the forest, the whole place was an ashram. So we used to go into the forest and there we would sit and discuss. Now when we are discussing so many things, we would even crack a joke, or we had that confusion and we would crack a joke as about, you know, how we'll ask this question to Gurudev, and you know, Gurudev said this, and straight from there we would go to Gurudev's talk, because we didn't drink tea, coffee, snacks and all were not there in the ashram. So we would go straight from there to the talks, and when we went to Gurudev's discourse, it's like as though he was there with us. The same joke, whatever questions we had, that answer. And as I said, even our sometimes words were repeated and made fun of. Many times we felt like going under the carpet, like, is he eavesdropping? He was nowhere around. It's only when we started Paduka Puja, Pad Puja at that time, when I read this Antah Sakshi, I said, where do we doubt that he is the inner witness who knows every thought of ours? And one who has contacted this inner witness is Jagat Sakshi. It will come later on. Antah Sakshi, one who knows every thought. And once you know that witness, that is the same witness in everyone, and therefore knows every thought. Now, sometimes that is a very eerie thing, huh? People get very frightened about it. Because, so somebody asked Gurudev, Gurudev, how is it that you know our thoughts? And there are other people, who are looking out for realized masters. So they have got little notions. So they would come and ask Gurudev, Swamiji, can you read people's thoughts? Some would be direct. Others would say, Swamiji, a realized master is all knowing. So he must be knowing everybody else's thoughts. Which means if you don't know my thoughts, and I want to know also if you know my thoughts, because very often about you also, I don't have very good thoughts, you know. I remember once, really speaking, common sense, you know what a person is thinking, you know. So sometimes we also say something and then, Swamiji, how did you know our thoughts? It was written all over your face. So I remember once this woman, she literally freaked out that day. And that was with me, and obviously, I'm not saying that I was reading her thoughts or any such thing, but she's so obvious. So I was just telling her, and she said, this is really very eerie. You seem to know every thought of mine. Nothing I can hide from you, you know? She was telling me. So I said, yeah, no, nobody could hide anything from my guru, so Antaryami, you know, he's my inner controller of my knowledge and thoughts, so he reveals it to me and I tell you. But she said, that's very eerie. Gurudev knew everybody's thoughts. They're so frightening. I said, listen, nobody can know your thoughts until and unless they love you. So Antah Sakshi means who's in the innermost recesses of your heart is love. And from a person who loves you, you yourself don't want to hide your thoughts. You can tell your deepest, darkest secret. So what are you hiding from the Guru anything? What are you hiding from Gurudev? And as youngsters, we had nothing to hide. Therefore, after that, we used to always carry Gurudev's photograph, even if we went for a restaurant or we went where we were, in fact, somebody's birthday party or something, we would carry, because Gurudev is a witness watching over us every minute. Because of that, you feel always protected. You feel always guided. At the same time, if you know he's always watching over you, can you even think of doing anything wrong? It became such a, even though as the inner witness, he's always the witness. Not that individual Swami Chinmayananda is a witness there, no? He is the witness, and he is the witness in our heart. Because the same consciousness in me is the consciousness in you. That's why it's called Chinmayam Vyapiyat Sarvam Trailokyam Sacharacharam. This Shivji is told to Parvati. That same consciousness pervades everybody. And therefore, that which is your inner witness is also Jagat Sakshi, the knower of all, witness of all. So once we were sitting with Gurudev, and somebody said, Swamiji, because they will test out whether Gurudev is also realized, there are such varieties. Actually, really speaking, nowadays we don't find those varieties. Because youngsters are not like that. So indirectly somebody was asking, we were sitting around him. I said, Swamiji, can realized masters read people's mind? And the next question would be whether you can read my mind. And it did come up. Gurudev said, yes, they can. But don't tell me to read your mind, because in one mind only there's so much filth. Why would anybody want to read the filthy minds of everybody? Shut up, that man only, I tell you. Who would want to read the filth in your mind? Is it not enough filth in my mind to read your mind, filthy mind? But Antar Sakshi, know all this. And the greatest practice we did was, and these are things you can practice. If you feel that Gurudev is with you, not only you feel always protected, but Guru Nanak Sahib also says, Guru Mere Sang Sada Hai Naal. And we literally used to carry Gurudev's photograph wherever we went. And therefore, never could you think also, and even if a thought came in your mind, Gurudev is watching. But the saddest day of my life became the happiest day of my life. Actually, even Gurudev, when he attained Mahasamadhi, it was like our life has gone away, you know. But he had prepared us for it. We knew that one day. And he used to tell us very openly. The Guru is the eternal reality, the very self in you. If you consider him to be the body, then one day you're going to cry. You know, like that he used to say in his last words at Vivek Chudamani, that video is also there. My Guru is gone. And in the newspapers reported that for everyone their life was Gurudev, but when his body arrived in Delhi, even the newspaper was surprised. All the journalists who had come there, they said everybody was talking in such a way as though their life has been taken away, but you didn't find people weeping, walloping, etc. In fact, very often they were remembering him with laughter and joy. No, with so much love. He never made you cry. Not even over his bodily departure. He never made you cry. Even there people were laughing.